There's a lot of renewable in Asia is new capacity, and that means it's a very different story because then renewables are simply the cheapest form of power. So I choose renewables. When you come to Europe, it's quite often a replacement. And then, yes, renewables might be the cheapest form of power, but somebody has to shut down their coal-fired plant, and they're usually not happy about it. What I think I've seen over the last few years in Asia is that we're still way behind Europe, but the interest from people in the acceptance of climate change, the realization that it is actually a big issue, is really coming up. I think that's an important driver. The second thing, I see a lot of push from corporates in Europe. For instance, maybe a small anecdote. I was supporting a project in Indonesia, small shoe factory, and they want to have rooftop solar. Now, they didn't care about the environment at all, but these people make shoes for Nike. And Nike said, hey guys, I pledge to be 100% renewable. And the shoe factory said, yeah, I don't care. And Nike said, well, I would like you to be renewable too. The shoe factory said, yeah, I don't care. Nike said, well, I'm sure somebody else can make my shoes. Oh, wait. And then suddenly, yeah, that person got interested. So you see it kind of dribbling through from
Right.
corporates. And you also see the corporates here. That traditionally very polluting corporates like PLN in Indonesia actually having a team looking into renewables, PTT in Thailand investing in solar and technology, so that it's really going here.